Praise the Lord. In our journey of following the Lord, in our journey of belonging to the Lord, in our journey of serving the Lord finds various ways through which He constantly rekindles our fire, which gets put off due to various reasons that happens on the way. Now, today's first reading is from the book of 1 Kings chapter 10. King Solomon was mightily blessed by God. We read in the beginning of the chapters, after receiving so much of property, kingdom from the father David, he realizes what he has received from the world is not sufficient for him. So he goes to the temple and he prays. And God appears to him and asks him, "My son, what do you want?" He says, "One of the fruits of the Holy Spirit I need. I need the wisdom." Wisdom is the gift of the Holy Spirit as well as it's also fruit. So he is crying for, "I need the Holy Spirit in my life. I need His fire. I need His presence. I need the wisdom and the knowledge which He gives to me. Only then I can survive on this broken world." God is pleased with him and enkindles the fire in his life as he enkindled in the life of David. David had a great passion for God. Even when he was a little boy, he by himself constantly rekindled his passion for God, his love for God. In Psalm 63 he says, "Like the dry ground hungers for the water, my soul thirsts for you, O Lord." He used to use the instrument, sing praises to God and keep alive the fire. Now father is no more. So God comes to help Solomon and says, "My son, you asked for my Holy Spirit. You asked for wisdom. Well, that's what you noticed in the life of your father. It is my wisdom made the shepherd boy into a great king. And you are now a great king. If you don't keep alive this fire, you will go back as a shepherd boy. You will go back to the street. The anointing and the gifts God has given to you is not permanent. You have to rekindle it again and again. It is in your hands. As long as breath is in you, you have to rekindle." We read in 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 6, when David lost everything. He lost his wife, he lost his friend, he lost every trick he used to survive, and at the end, 600 people with whom he lived, they were about to stone him to death. That is the moment he rekindles his fire. The Bible says he built up his relationship with God when he lost everything. So as long as you have breath, you have the opportunity to rekindle the fire. When things go wrong, we begin to get back to the world. When things are built up by the world, we are being taken up by the world and we move with the world. But world is world. Worldly people are worldly people. Your friends are your friends. Don't throw your call at help of your friends. or at the help of what you get from the world. So we need to constantly rekindle to be in the fire of the Lord to face the struggle of the world. We find in the book of Acts chapter 28, when Paul was in the ship, he told the captain not to go in the direction in which they wanted to go. But he was only a prisoner, so they did not listen to him. They went as the experts have directed him, and the captain led the ship, and it went into shipwreck, a storm, and it is there a vision is given to Paul, and he says, none of us will be perished, because the Lord in whom I worship, whom I love, in whom I have trusted, he appeared to me last night and said, his angel told me that none of us will perish. Amidst the storm, everyone is hungry. A man who received the fire, a man who received the vision, a man who lives in the fire, he alone lives, and he makes others to live, even in the storm. Storms will come in everyone's life, but he who keeps up the fire remains a blessing and makes everyone to be a blessing. So when everyone is sad and broken that they are going through storm and shipwreck and their ship is going to be broken into pieces, not Paul, a man who had the vision of the Lord, who had the burning fire even in the storm. And he took the bread, he thanked God, he ate the bread and made others to eat. And as he promised, as he said, the next day the ship got into pieces. People, everybody got one each piece, and they reached the shore called Malta. And in Acts chapter 28, we read verse 1 onwards, the people of Malta were so kind. They saw these people are coming with cold, shivering, hungry, and they gave their best food to eat, to warm up them. Now Paul, he went and brought some sticks and he knit the fire. When there is cold, when there is shivering, the Bible says Paul knit the fire. Things will happen. Shipwreck will come in your life. Your own boat may be turned into pieces. But you have to keep alive the fire. Nobody will keep your fire. You have to keep alive the fire in the Lord. If you look at the human beings, if you look at the broken world, if you look at things that are going all around, you are lost. There are so many people who are trying to get help from the world. They are going to be doomed. There are so many people who are crying over, oh, all around me, so much a problem, problem, problem. They are going to be doomed. We are called to live among the problems until we are in the world. But if we knit the fire, we will continue to keep ourselves warm. When he knit the fire, a snake did not leave Paul. It came in. There are so many people. But a man who knit the fire, into his hands it comes. And if it touches, people will die. So the people who looked at said, look, this fellow may be a prisoner, may be a murderer. He tried to escape, but the snakes did not leave him. He is going to die. But he threw it into the fire. Till the last minute, the enemy will be after you. The snake will be after you to make you zero. But if you knit the fire, you can throw it into the fire. If you don't knit the fire, you will be victim to it. Victim to the evil forces. It is not the problem in the past or today or tomorrow is going to decide you. It is your capacity to check yourself and your capacity to move into the fire, to knit the fire of your life, is going to decide your life.